Hello YouTube, I am Kevin the Dane, and today we're going to take a look at the new VRay 3.5. I just received a mail from Chaos Group, and they are proclaiming that their new render is up to 7 times as fast as the old one. Now that's a bold claim, and maybe also a little vague, so let's find out how fast it really is. And while we're at it, let's also take a look at one of the new features, the interactive lens effects. So let's do it. So let's go ahead and download it, and while it's downloading, let's open up a version of 3D Studio Max and take a test scene and try to render it and see how long it takes with the VRay 3.4. Okay, so I've got a scene here. It's actually an old scene, it's a couple of years old, and I just opened it a minute ago to clean it up and reset the render settings, so that everything is reset to VRay 3.4 standard settings. The only thing I changed was the noise threshold levels and the noise threshold level on the DMC sampler, because I've added a VRay denoiser element, and I think the denoiser can take the rest of the noise that'll be left. So let's just try to render it out and see how long it takes. And if you're wondering, then yes, this part is sped up. I don't have some sort of supercomputer or anything. So this actually is 36 minutes in the making. So what we can see here is still a bit noisy, and that is because the increased noise thresholds. But I added the denoiser element. So if we take a look at the denoiser, we can see that it's totally clean and no noise. Of course, there are still some artifacts, and that will always be present when you're using the denoiser, but I think you can use it with great effect. And now let's close this down and install the VRay 3.5 and see if we can beat the score of 36 minutes. And I'm just speeding over all this installation process because I can. But if you take a look here, you can see that Chaos Group is now prompting me to install their online license service, which means that I can now just throw away my dongle. So let's open up 3D Studio Max again and open up the last version of the scene. And we will re-render and see how long it takes. And while we're rendering, let's check out a few new features of VRay 3.5. See, what Chaos Group have added here is a new GPU accelerated lens effects. This means that you can take a look at your glare and your bloom, and you can apply them while you're rendering. You do not need to wait until the render is done. So while you're tweaking and adjusting here, you will notice that immediately the render looks a lot cleaner. And that is because the frame buffer have switched to the effect results element in the frame buffer. And it will show you the bloom and the glare, and it will also show you the VRay denoiser effects. So what you're seeing here is the denoised image with the bloom and the glare. Now let's just rush over all this rendering and see where we end up time-wise. So as you can see, it took only 24 minutes to finish this render, and the settings were exactly the same as they were before in the VRay 3.4. So that means we actually cut the render time down to 2/3 of the original render time in this specific scene. Now, if we do compare the two images, we can see that there are some slight changes to the images, especially if you look in the bottom of the lamps, you can see that something is changed with the lighting, and that is probably due to the probabilistic lighting algorithm. I'm gonna play around with this some more, and I will give you a more in-depth review later on, but if you have any questions, please post them in the comments below.
So, not quite 7 times as fast, but still, 50% is a significant improvement. I really do think that Vlada and the team at Chaos Group deserve the SciTech award that they were just awarded. And if you want to check out what me and the guys did with the scene we just rendered, please check it out. There's a video here and there's a link in the description below. Please do like, subscribe, share, tweet, whatever floats your boat. And cut!